Expenses and submitting expense reports are the bane of the corporate world. But Zoho has an app that can help you with that in tracking your expenses in an expense report, as well as seeing those expenses in your CRM so you can see how much money you've spent on each client. Hi, I'm Susan Clark, and welcome to Zoho Quick Tips. Usually I talk about CRM, but today I want to talk about the app Zoho Expense. It's most of the videos that I see online talk about how to use it in the web app, but I really think that most people are going to use it on their phone. It's very easy to use. There's a couple of things that I think it would be helpful for you to know, but let's look at how you might keep it keep all of your expenses on your phone and then how they display inside of CRM. If you go to the end of the video, I can tell you why you'd want to use the web version versus the version on your phone. Let's take a look. Most people, I think, will enter their expenses from their phone. It is pretty easy to download. Go to either the Apple Play Store or the Android apps area and download Zoho Expense. I have it already loaded on my phone, and so I'm just going to go ahead and open it up. When you open it up the first time, you'll need to log in with your normal Zoho email ID and password, and it'll come into your expense screen. Creating expenses in Zoho Expense is actually super easy. Most of it's pretty self-explanatory, but I just wanted to go over a couple of things that might not be quite as evident. But at any rate, if you're going to do an expense report, the very first thing you do before creating an expense is to go create a report. So a report is a folder that will hold all of your expenses for your current time period. You can see I have a couple of them that have been approved. I've got one in draft mode and I've got one that's rejected. So I can show you a little bit about that as well. So I'm just going to create a new report though by clicking on the plus. And usually you're going to put in a title. If it's a trip, you could put in the trip name. I'm going to put in 2018 December. So this is my December expense report, and it covers, I'm just going to say when it covers. Usually you can pick the time period that it's normally going to cover, so you know kind of where your expenses are coming from. If it was a trip, you can put in a purpose, you know, what was the purpose of the trip. If it was a trip to see a specific customer, you can select a customer. I'm not going to do that here. I'm going to select my customers on an individual expense basis. Projects are not Zoho projects if you're using that app. They are projects that have been created in either books or expense, so that this is a specific project that you're going to credit all these expenses toward. Usually your submit to will already be there, but if not, go ahead and click who's the person that's responsible for submitting. Since I usually do my own expense accounts, mine doesn't show up there. So I'm just going to click save because now I've created a report folder that I can use to create my expenses. And I'm going to go back to the home page. So then once you have a report, it's pretty easy to create an expense. You can click this if you want to, or you can click this. It makes no difference. I like clicking the plus because it gives me better options. So there's going to be a couple of things I want to talk about: adding an expense, capturing a receipt, adding mileage, and adding per diem. So let's look at adding an expense, because really and truly adding expense and capturing a receipt is almost exactly the same thing. It's just that here it'll ask me to capture the receipt at the end. So I'm going to click that. Notice it automatically puts in today's date. And if you capture, there is an option to OCR or optical character recognition, but to me it's like a little bit slow, so I just almost as soon type it in. And in this one that I have here, I'm just going to put in Wendy's because that's the expense I have to show. This is the thing that is probably the, you know, what you would need to know. This is, do you want the company to pay you back? Or did you use a company credit card? So if I paid cash, I might want to claim reimbursement. Notice as I scroll down, I can say how I paid for it. But if I uncheck this, then it allows me to go down and pick the paid through, which is where I would pick the credit card that I use for the company. So in this case, I want to claim reimbursement because I paid cash. I can itemize if it was a really long list or something. Let's say I went to a hardware store to get stuff for a trade show. I could itemize different things if I wanted to. Notice there are some red fields. That those are going to be required fields. I'm going to pick a category, and this is just, you have to find it very quickly. It was just really a meals, and each company is going to have a different types of categories. Your company admin is going to pick out the exact wording, but you'll pick the one that most likely matches everything, and then you're going to put in the amount. My amount was $15.11. Tax is only for international people, so you probably won't see that on your account. The most important reason to fill out a description is if this expense will be sent to a client, and you will put it on their invoice for reimbursement to the client. Let's say you were doing traveling, they're paying your travel expenses. Merchant, this field does not go over to books or invoicing. So if you want the client to know where you spent the time, you would probably need to put a description in here of what you actually did. So in this case, I'm just gonna put in the date, Wendy's lunch, close enough. We're not going to worry about spelling. I paid cash, so you can click this, and if it was a personal credit card, you could put it in. Here's the reason why we had to add the report first. So I'm going to click this and pick, this is only going to show me unsubmitted reports, and this is the one that I want to put it on because it's my December report. I could charge it against a customer. That one. There it is, Yellow Jersey Bikes. It's at your option. Reference is the same thing. Reference is a way for you to like give a purchase order number or more information about this particular expense. There's the attendees button. So the attendees would be if you had a lunch and you invited several clients and you wanted it to show or to be attributed to particular contacts. The nice advantage of the customer field and the attendees field is if you're also using Zoho CRM, this expense will show on that client record so that you can see that a certain amount of expense was attributed to them. Now, I can attach the receipt if I have it, but in this case, I'm going to take a photo of it. I've got my phone right here. I'm just going to take this, and I have the receipt right here. Notice that receipt will capture much better if you're on a dark background, just so you know. I'm going to get it kind of level. Once you get it level, usually I tap my finger right in the middle, and that will allow the phone to actually really capture it pretty quickly, and then I'm just going to click the button to take a picture. If it looks okay, then I'm just going to say, yes, that works fine. Click OK. I don't need to edit it in any way. I could crop it, but I don't think it's really necessary. It looks fine. I'm just going to say yes. So now the receipt is there, and it looks good. I'm just going to click Save. So now I have one expense in my expense account. So I could add another. I'm going to click the plus here, and the capture receipt is exactly the same as this. I'm just going to show you very quickly. Okay. Notice it's going to be exactly the same. I'm not going to continue through this. I can start the auto scan, which it'll try and read it, but it, particularly with crumpled receipts like this, it's going to be really hard. And I'm not going to show you because the auto scan will just work or it won't, but I'm just going to say add manually. And see, notice that I can start to add other things. It gives me previous things, some ideas in case I want to do that. So I'm going to come back out. I'm going to say, do I want to discard? Because I really don't want to add another receipt. What I want to do is talk about adding mileage, which is another kind of receipt. So there are three ways to add mileage if you're capturing it on your phone. The really nice way is using GPS, because you can start and it will read where you are now. And when you get to your destination, you know, you can stop and it will actually record the mileage for where you are. And you can see I went zero distance. Do you want to claim reimbursement? Do you expect the company to pay you money for this? Or is this on the company car and you're just letting them know you spent this much? So I'm going to say I'm going to claim reimbursement. I could manually change the distance if I wanted to. It's going to automatically, let me just manually change it to give you an idea. It was 25 miles. And notice once I come out of it, this is the standard rate for this current 2018 year. So it's going to automatically calculate the amount that might be reimbursed, and you can add it to your expense account. I don't need to add it to that customer. Notice it's just making it easier, particularly if you're on a trip. It just keeps a lot of the same things to make it easier for it to go through your expenses a lot. But if you forgot to turn on your GPS, you can use the odometer if you want to and put the start reading and the end reading. I don't use this one very much because I forget to do the start and end reading. It never seems to work. But there is the option also of manually. If you know how far it is to, from one location to another, you can just manually put in the distance, let's say 23 miles or something like that. And again, it's going to automatically tab there. It's going to automatically calculate what it, how much you should be reimbursed for. And then again, you can select the report and the customer however you want to. If you had a receipt, let's say a gas receipt or something, you could add it to this expense. I'm not going to save this expense either. That Zoho automatically updates your account with the agreed upon U.S. tax rate. And it's based on the year. By the way, it has a lot, several years. Next week, if you retroactively put in an expense for December, it'll use the December rate instead of the January rate. If I had an expense that I charged to the company credit card, I want to add that one very quickly. And I don't, let's see, I'm going to take this off. And I don't want to claim reimbursement because it was to the company credit card. Let's say it was a meal for something like that. And I would say paid through, and it was paid through the company Amex card. I can add it to the report, and the meal was $25, we'll say. And I'm just going to click save. I have one more kind of expense I want to add, and that is if you have per diem expenses. In other words, you're traveling and you're allowed to spend, say, $35 or $50 per day, and you're not required to submit any kind of receipts. So you can add per diem expenses, and I would say, do you want to claim reimbursement? Yes, because I paid for this out of this, or no, I don't really want to claim reimbursement because I've got it. So I'm going to say, yes, I'm claiming reimbursement. Notice the category per diem is already filled in and it's grayed out. I can't even change it. So basically, you just want to know how many days are you claiming reimbursement for. And let's say I'm going to claim 3 days. And the company amount you can see in gray right here is $50. So once I click out of that, it's going to reimburse me $150 for the 3 days of per diem expenses, whether it was food or whatever. I can select a payment mode and just say really and truly, I did most of that on credit card, on my own personal credit card. Notice it didn't allow me to take the Amex because I'm claiming reimbursement. If I put it all on the company credit card, then it would give me the option to put in the company credit card. Again, I'm going to add it to the report of my December expense account, and that's all I'm going to do. Click save. So now I think I have all the different kinds expenses attached to this report. I've got this one that I ask for reimbursement. Notice these are all non-billable. I ask for, this is non-reimbursable, so it's $25. This is reimbursable. So the total of the expense account is this, but $25 was not reimbursable because I put it on the company credit card. So the company will pay me this amount, even though the credit, my expense report will be for this amount. So, you know, looks pretty good. Once you have the expense account, notice it's in draft mode, I need to submit it. So I look at it, review it, everything looks fine. And if you're an Android, you'll see this little ellipsis thing at the upper right where you can click submit. If you are an iPhone user, you'll see at the bottom, there'll be something that will allow you to submit. So I'm going to click submit. And it's asking me who to submit to. So I submit it, and actually, because I'm submitting it to myself, it's auto-approved, but I can see very quickly that it will be approved. Now, in my, just so you know, I had some things in my inbox. I'm just going to pull my inbox over very quickly. This morning that says, hey, you have a few expenses that you recorded, but you haven't reported yet. So if you do have expenses and you haven't submitted your expense account, you're going to get some kind of nag emails that say, hey, you need to be sure and don't let those expenses get out of date. Because there is a limit usually set by your admin on how long you can have an expense and not submit it and still get reimbursed for it. See, if you are the person in charge of approving or rejecting, you can go here to look at the reports that need to be approved, and you can select them. This one was already approved, but I could say reject it, or I could do some other things if I want to. So you'll be sent an email that says, hey, somebody has submitted an expense account in that is requesting that you approve it. Rejected, for instance, like I had this one that was rejected. Just be sure and go in and figure out why it was rejected. Let's say this meal, you're not allowed to charge coffee or drinks or whatever, something like that. You can remove it from the report. Notice I'm just clicking the little ellipsis to the right of the expense. I can remove it from the report. And then once I've removed it, I can resubmit the report for approval by somebody. So while you can do most everything on your phone, I did want to talk very quickly about why you might want to use the web. In order to go look at your expense account on the web, you just go to expense.zoho.com and you come into your dashboard page. One of the reasons that you might log in at this area is if you get receipts via email, let's say hotel bills, and you just want to include the hotel expense. So you can go here to your receipt box and drag or click to attach the receipt if you want to, and it'll just pull it into that expense account. So it'll help you with anything that you're receiving via email. But also notice here in the receipt inbox, I thought I would show you, if you scroll down, there's a little thing down here that says upload your Chrome extension. So I wanted to pull it to this page. This is a handy one if you do get a lot of expense receipts via email, where you can add to Chrome, and it basically you can take just a snippet, you can mouse and draw the window of what you want, and it will automatically upload receipts from any Chrome window. So that actually works fairly nicely well. Let's say you buy something online and you can just drag a picture of the receipt, or you can take the receipt like this and pull it over into your expense account. So I would use it for that reason. Other than that, if you're submitting, unless you're an admin where you need to change things or add users, you can pretty much control everything about expense from your phone. I hope you found the video helpful today. If you do, be sure and give it a thumbs up. And if you'd like to subscribe to the channel, be sure and do that and click the bell to the side of the subscribe button, and you'll get an email each time I release a new video. As always, if there's anything we can do to help you, if you need help with customizing, with training, with design, importing, whatever, just give us a shout. Thanks.